So we understand the nickname for this research is called Sprint Mind. What exactly is it? And understand a big part of it also involves hypertension. Why so, Doctor?
Sure. Well, hypertension or high blood pressure is present about 50% of American adults. And so what the SPRINT trial is, systolic blood pressure intervention trial, we started in 2010 and we compared a goal of 120 versus 140 systolic. And so
the,
if you-
That's the upper number,
and that's
right?
That's the upper number.
Okay.
So 120 over 80, it would be 120.
Okay.
So so we compared those two, and then after about 5 years, with an average follow-up of about 3 years, in 2015, we actually stopped the study because it had reduced cardiovascular events, heart, stroke, heart failure, mm-hmm. cardiovascular death, and all deaths by about 25 to 30%.
Really?
So that was stopped in 2015. But we continued to follow the participants looking at testing cognition.
Yeah.
So, Dr. Johnson, does dementia play anything in this as well, or is it mainly just high blood pressure that you looked at?
Well, we know that hypertension is a risk factor for mild cognitive impairment and dementia. And we also know that dementia is a serious condition in the United States.
Sure.
About 6 million people have dementia, and it's estimated that number will triple by 2050.
Well, and I wonder if it has increased over the last number of years. I'm imagining that hypertension has, as we have become more overweight.
It has increased. In fact, dementia is the sixth leading cause of death in the United States.
So is it because the blood flow doesn't get to the brain on a regular basis because you're constricted, or did the study look at the why?
Well, in the Sprint Mind study, what we found was that the systolic goal of less than 120 reduced the risk of mild cognitive impairment by 19%. And that is, it reduced the risk of having trouble remembering things, having trouble thinking about things, and having trouble reasoning.
Is 19% pretty high?
That is a significant reduction.
Wow.
And it's the first treatment that we've ever been able to show prevents mild cognitive impairment.
Wow.
Let's also bring this a little bit closer to home. A lot of people may be wondering, why was this research done here in Memphis, Tennessee, UT Health Science Center, as well as the VA Medical Center? Why Memphis?
Yeah, so part of it was we applied for it, but obviously we have a lot of hypertension here in the Mid-South. And so I actually brought in about 25 VA centers around the country into Sprint.
Wow.
We had 102 centers overall.
So this is a big
study.
And then
we had a local site here at the Memphis VA and also at the University of Tennessee. Mm-hmm. And Karen and I were also both involved in the overall national leadership. She was the vice chair of the steering committee and I was on the steering committee.
So what is the takeaway for folks out there who have high blood pressure pretty, you know, consistently, chronically?
Well, I think one of the more important messages is you need to know what your numbers are. What is your blood pressure? So if you don't know what your systolic blood pressure is, go get it checked.
Is this for people of all ages or mainly folks over 50, over 60?
I would say it's important in all ages to know what your numbers are. And then if your blood pressure is high, you need to go to your doctor and talk about treatment.
Okay. And it's very important how the blood pressure is measured. Unfortunately, it's not measured that well in many clinical settings.
Okay.
People should sit quietly for 5 minutes, have the proper cuff size, those kinds of things. There are a number of things that often are not done in clinical practice. You can do that at home, and you can check it at home as well.
But do it the right way.
By all means.
Thank you so much.
And Johnson.
And also the goal of 120 or 130 is very important to try and keep the blood pressure
to try to get there.
We'll certainly keep it in mind.
Thanks.
Thank you for your time.
Thank you.
Appreciate you both being here.
Mm-hmm.